Hi, we're Glenn and Susan Hirschberger, missionaries to Panama City, Panama with Converge and the IBC. We wanted to take the time to give you a video blog and an update of our progress here in Panama City, the things that are happening, the good and the bad, the highs and the lows.
One of our highs here in Panama City is the fresh produce market. We went the other day and were able to fill the back of the car with papaya and pineapple, watermelon. You get mangoes and mangosteen and avocados and all kinds of fruits and vegetables from a tropical area. Filled the back of the car and it was under right around $10.
One of the lows that we're experiencing is adjusting to the temperature and the high humidity. And so it is not uncommon for us to feel very drained at the end of the day. And right now it's sunny, it's warm, it's probably mid-80s, high humidity. And so that has been an adjustment for us.
Another one of the highs here is the fresh fish market. We're able to get fresh seafood and fish caught that morning and have purchased corvina, which is a sea bass, fresh tuna steaks, shrimp, and it's all under $6 a pound. So it's wonderful.
Another high that we have is just meeting a lot of people. We mentioned the Breakfast Club. We've been meeting people from Peru, Britain, New Zealand, Canada. On the elevator the other day, we met a boy from Bolivia, a lady that washed her car. She was from Nicaragua, and they speak English. And so it's been an adventure to go out and listen and meet these people really on a day-to-day basis.
One of the lows about living in the city, though, is the traffic. It's kind of hard when you know you only have to travel about 2 miles and need to plan a half an hour and more to get there because the traffic can be so congested sometimes. Even waiting for the elevator can take a whole lot longer sometimes the days than others.
Another low for us is just the obstacles on the sidewalks. There's big potholes, big cracks, nothing is uniform or even. There could be wires that are hanging down from utility poles, and so when you go out, we've discovered that we have to be alert at all times. Plus, crossing the streets, pedestrians don't have the right of way, so we cross at our peril. So,
one of the other highs living here is the parrots in the park. Our apartment overlooks a nice little park, and there are beautiful bright green parrots in the trees in the mornings and in the evenings, and that's been really neat.
The downside is they squawk. They make a lot of noise, and so early in the morning we hear them, and then later in the afternoon we hear them again, and it's just an adjustment living really next to a park. Another high that we have is our Spanish lessons. We get tutored from a Spanish English speaking teacher twice a week for about an hour and a half. And Maria is not only teaching us the basics of the Spanish language, but also cultural things. So that's been a real plus. That's been a real high for us.
One of the lows about that, though, is that sometimes when we practice our Spanish out in the community, you feel very misunderstood. We've gotten some pretty funny looks when we've made some requests from people, and I just wonder what exactly I said to these people when they look at us sometimes. Another plus of being up here on the 19th floor is that there really aren't many bugs. Bugs just don't fly this high. And so we have no screens on the windows, we can leave the doors wide open, and in the evenings we often get a really nice breeze coming through, and that's been really great. One of the lows that goes with that, though, is the reaction to the bug bites. I have had a couple of bites down on the ground and have had strange reactions to the bites.
Well, thanks for watching, and we wanted to end with the high and let you know that we have a Bible study every Sunday night. It's a group that's growing. We're studying the book of Acts, and it's really been a joy to open up God's Word and just dissect that. So that's every Sunday night. If you pray for us, we'd appreciate that. We're adding people to it, and we think that that base of people that attend will certainly come to the church. Also, on Wednesday night, we have a prayer and planning session, and we're just dreaming, we're visionary, and we're talking about the DNA of LifeBridge International Church. It's a small planning launch group right now, but again, we pray and we'd ask you to join us in prayer for the addition of more people for the launch. Again, we appreciate your support, your prayer coverage, your faithfulness to us, your financial support, and those of you that have already made trips down to visit us, we appreciate that. It's a huge encouragement to us. So thanks again, and please let us know your feedback, what you think about this video blog. We'd like to do this at least once a month and give you just a taste of our life as missionaries in Panama City. Thank you.